Dear friends, in this webinar, we shall learn when to initiate feeds and how much to feed in low birth weight infants. All low birth weight infants should be started on full enteral feeds immediately after birth. For outborn units, full feeds should be started at admission. The enteral feeds may be in the form of direct breastfeeding, express breast milk, or in rare cases, formula. There are only a few exceptions in whom full oral feeds are not started at birth or at admission. These include weight less than 1000 grams, or if gestation is known, the gestation less than 29 weeks, shock requiring inotropes, respiratory failure requiring invasive mechanical ventilation, severe asphyxia, that is defined as no cry by 5 minutes of life, or need for chest compressions, active and ongoing seizures at admission, obvious abdominal distension with or without blood or bile stain, vomiting or aspirate, and finally surgical conditions of gastrointestinal tract like intestinal atresia. If any of these conditions are present, we have to keep the baby nil per oral and reassess the baby after 12 to 24 hours. Upon reassessment, we should check if the baby is stable. That means the baby maintains normal temperature, heart rate, respiratory rate, saturations, and capillary refill time with or without any support. If the baby is stable, we can start oral feeds. For babies with birth weight less than 1000 grams, we usually start with MEN, that is minimal enteral nutrition, or trophic feeds. This means giving express breast milk at 10 to 20 ml per kg per day for 1 to 2 days and gradually increasing the feed by 20 ml per kg per day. In other conditions such as respiratory failure, shock, asphyxia or seizures, we can be little more aggressive. We can start at 25 to 50% of the required daily intake, and if the baby accepts this well, we can gradually increase to full feeds in the next 24 to 48 hours. If the baby is less than 1500 grams, we usually start with MEN and then gradually increase the feeds by 20 ml per kg per day. In babies with abdominal distension or surgical conditions of gastrointestinal tract, we can start feeds if there is no abdominal distension or vomiting in the last 24 hours and the abdomen is soft. In these babies, we usually start feeds at 10 to 20 ml per kg per day and increase the feeds very slowly by 20 to 30 ml per kg per day. In all the babies in whom feeds are started slowly, we have to assess if the baby is tolerating feeds by careful inspection of the abdomen before each feed. We shall learn about monitoring for feed intolerance in a separate webinar. If feeds are increased gradually, the baby has to be kept on IV fluids till the baby reaches 100 ml per kg per day of feeds, after which we can stop IV fluids. The daily requirement of fluids in low birth weight babies is provided in this table. For babies with birth weight of 1500 grams or more, we start at 60 ml per kg on the day 1 of life. We increase the amount by 20 ml per kg every day till the baby reaches 160 ml per kg by day 7. In very low birth weight babies, that is birth weight less than 1500 grams, we usually start at 80 ml per kg on day 1 of life. The amount is increased by 15 ml per kg every day till the baby reaches 150 ml per kg by day 7. Feeds should be given every 2 to 3 hours in all low birth weight babies. Thank you.